أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا نحن نزلنا عليك القرآن تنزيلا فاصبر لحكم ربك إنا نحن نزلنا عليك القرآن تنزيلا فاصبر لحكم ربك ولا تطع منهم آثما أو كفورا واذكر اسم ربك بكرة وأصيلا إنا نحن نزلنا عليك القرآن تنزيلا فاصبر لحكم ربك ولا تطع منهم آثما أو كفورا واذكر اسم ربك بكرة وأصيلا ومن الليل فاسجد له وسبحه ليلا طويلا ومن الليل فاسجد له وسبحه ليلا طويلا
إن هؤلاء يحبون العاجلة ويذرون وراءهم يوما ثقيلا نحن خلقناهم وشددنا أسرهم وإذا شئنا بدلنا أمثالهم تبديلا
نحن خلقناهم وشددنا أسرهم وإذا شئنا بدلنا أمثالهم تبديلا.
إن هذه تذكرة فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه سبيلا. وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء الله إن الله كان عليما حكيما. إن الله كان عليما حكيما يدخل من يشاء في رحمته والظالمين أعد لهم عذابا أليما. صدق الله العظيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Oh.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال أيضا: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. وقال: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وبعد: Indeed, all praise and glory is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His aid and His forgiveness. We believe in Him and rely upon Him. We seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection and refuge against the evil of our own souls and against the evil of our impious deeds. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, none can misguide. And whomsoever is misguided, none can guide him except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we testify and we bear witness to the fact that there's no one worthy of worship except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is alone without any partner. And we testify and we bear witness to the fact that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's last messenger and his perfect worshiper. My dear respected brothers and sisters, my name is Rizwan Ali. I'm an imam from the Islamic Center of Naperville, in town this weekend to visit some relatives, and I'm blessed and honored to be among you here today. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He's gathered us here in this blessed gathering, that He gathers us in a much better gathering in Jannat al-Firdaus with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and with our brothers and sisters, the Shuhada of Gaza. Ameen. When we think about the issues that are taking place in Gaza, one of the questions that people ask is, what do we want? What is our goal? And as a Muslim community, as a Muslim ummah, our goal is very simple, that we want people to be able to practice their faith in safety and security peacefully. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, He tells us in Surah An-Nur that there's a way that we can achieve this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nur, verse 55, said, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises the believers and those that do good deeds, لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give people success in the land and give them stability as He has given to those before them. وَلَيُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمُ الَّذِي ارْتَضَى لَهُمْ وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them sound and grounded and make them and give them the ability to practice their faith, the religion that He has chosen for them. And He will replace their fear with safety and security. But what's the condition? يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا, that we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and we don't associate any partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ بَعْدَ ذَٰلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ, and whoever disbelieves after that, they are clearly rebellious and obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, if we want respect, izzah, as a Muslim community, as a Muslim ummah, then we need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we want safety and security, we need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our hopes, goals, aspirations, all must be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِن يَنْصُرْكُمُ اللَّهُ فَلَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ وَإِن يَخْذُلْكُمْ فَمَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَنْصُرُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al Imran that if Allah helps you, no one can overcome you. But if Allah leaves you, who besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be able to help you? Let the believers put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us some more conditions. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Establish salah. Give zakah. And obey the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so that you may receive the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we are more in need of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than anyone needs anything else. Sometimes people say, a fish needs water. We are more in need of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than that fish needs water. We are more in need of the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than we even need air to breathe. Why? Because if a fish doesn't have water, it'll die. If we don't have oxygen, it'll die. And that will end our dunya. But if we don't have that mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will not only end our dunya, but end our akhirah as well. How do we get that mercy? We establish salah. We give zakah. And we obey the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when we're looking at these things happening in Gaza and elsewhere, it's very, very important that all of us collectively, as a Muslim community, as individuals, as a community, as an ummah, come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Establish our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Establish our connection with the people and the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Put our hopes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But that's not the only thing that we should be doing. Yes, it is the most important thing, without a doubt. But Allah said in this ayah, وَأَطِيُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. And obey the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so that we may receive that mercy. How did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam address the issues that were taking place in the society? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam definitely started with that base that all of our goals, hopes, and aspirations are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we have to do whatever we can to make sure that we can stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. Absolve ourselves of responsibility and say, oh Allah, when we saw these things happening, we didn't just sit there idly. We didn't say that we don't care, it's not our problem. We did whatever we could in whatever capacity that we could to raise the voice of the voiceless. And that's what it means to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as well. And I want to focus on three things in addition to our spirituality, which is the base. I want to focus on two or three things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam emphasized. The first thing is the importance of unity. We have to be united as a Muslim community, as a Muslim ummah. This issue that's taking place is not a Palestinian issue. It's not an Arab issue. It is a Muslim issue because Masjid al-Aqsa and the Palestine area is sacred to each and every one of us, but it's also a humanitarian issue. And my brothers and sisters, you know, I come from the Chicago and the Naperville Masjid, which I'm at, Wadir, the six-year-old boy who was killed, 20 minutes away from us. Do you think that person who killed him cared which madhab he followed? Do you think he cared whether his family celebrated Thanksgiving or not, or gave candy out at Halloween or not? Yes, those are discussions that we can have internally. But in the grand scheme of things, we are one ummah and we need to be united as an ummah. There's a proper time and place to have these conversations, but this is not that time. As an ummah, doesn't matter where we come from, we unite on this issue of standing up for our brothers and sisters who are being oppressed all over the world. Some may say, okay, there's oppression all over the world, which is true, and we should speak up about all of these issues. But why Palestine specifically? Because our tax dollars are being used to fund the atrocities and the crimes that are taking place there, and we have that responsibility and a right to speak up and say that we don't want our money to be used in that way. And we need to be united in that. Another thing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did is that he united the Muslims under the banner of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, and he gave them the freedom to use whatever talents they had to serve Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the best possible way. So if you look at some of the companions radiallahu anhum, some of them were more spiritually inclined. They would fast more, they would make more dua. Alhamdulillah, there's a lot of khair in that. But there are others, like Khalid bin Walid radiallahu anhu, who was more militarily sound. There was others like Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu anhu, who was more financially wealthy. There was others like Hassan ibn Thabit, who was a poet. There was others like Zayd ibn Thabit, who was young, but he was brilliant. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told each of them, to serve Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in whatever capacity they could under the banner of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. We have people in our community that mashallah, they're very spiritually inclined. We'll make qunut, we'll come back to the masjid, we'll encourage other people to do so. Alhamdulillah, there's goodness in that and there's a need for that. But we also need people who are financially wealthy to help support organizations and individuals and people that are standing up for truth. Raising money for our brothers and sisters in Gaza so that when aid is released over there, they can have that. We also need people that can organize demonstrations. We also need people that can be active on social media. This is a collective effort that we all have to help each other and support each other and move together towards the right direction. If we spend our time criticizing, this is not going to bring benefit, this is not going to bring benefit, this is against the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We lift each other up, we don't push each other down. We raise the morale, we don't demoralize people. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam always told us, bashir wa la tunaffiru, that give people hope and good news. Don't cause people to be disappointed, rejected, and hate each other. Wa a'udhu billah, may Allah protect us all and forgive us all. Number two, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted us to be educated as a Muslim ummah and a Muslim community. And we know that the first ayah that was revealed was Iqra. We know that khayrukum man ta'allama al-Qur'an wa 'allama, the best of you that are those that learn and teach. But we need to be educated about the history. You know, a lot of times people, they just talk about October 7th. But what happened before that? We as a Muslim community need to know. We as a Muslim community also must be aware and educate ourselves about the civil rights struggles that happened in this country. Some of the things that we're talking about and we're hearing about, apartheid state, right? Different set of laws. This happened right here in the United States. And the same struggles that we're going through for the Palestinian brothers and sisters, the African American brothers and sisters in this country face those same challenges. Imagine having different water fountains for black people and white people, different roads, different buses, different seats. Imagine how a person, they would drain the pool. If a black girl put her foot in the toe, her toe in the pool, they would drain the pool. The dehumanization that we're seeing in Palestine of our brothers and sisters happened here. What are some of the strategies that the people used here? Same thing, right? They were connected to political officials. They had a relationship with them, but they weren't dependent on them. Eventually, yes, those officials that disappointed them time and time again, eventually those are the same ones that pass or propose a Civil Rights Act. The media, awareness, demonstrations, these are all strategies that were used here to change and raise public awareness about the situation that was taking place. Many of the people in our society don't know the atrocities that our brothers and sisters in Palestine and Gaza go through every day. They're completely oblivious. But it's our responsibility to raise that awareness in whatever capacity that we can. So we need to be educated ourselves and educate others. And number three, we have to have hope. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even in the most difficult circumstances, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will tell the companions radiallahu anhum that I don't fear poverty for you. I fear that the dunya will become accessible to you. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was migrating from Mecca to Medina, and there was a bounty on his head, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Suraqa at that time, how happy or how are you going to feel when we get the treasures of the Persians? And the Persians were the superpower at that time. Look at the faith and the trust that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we as Muslims have to have that faith and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that inna al-aqibata lil-muttaqeen. The end result will always be for the people of taqwa, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ghafir said, فَاصْبِرْ إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٍّ. Have patience. Indeed, without a doubt, the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is true. فَإِمَّا نُرِيَنَّكَ بَعْضَ الَّذِي نَعِدُهُمْ أَوْ نَتَوَفَّيَنَّكَ فَإِلَيْنَا يُرْجَعُونَ. Perhaps we may show you some of what we have promised them, or we will cause you to die. But know that everyone's going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear respected brothers and sisters, the results are not in our hands. The results are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our responsibility is to make effort and put our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know, without a doubt, that the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is true. Politicians, people, organizations, people may disappoint us. Allah will never disappoint us. People may break their promises. Allah will never break His promise. But it's our responsibility to do whatever we can in whatever capacity that we can so that we can stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, "Oh Allah, I tried." I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants all hidayah and tawfiq. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us all the ability to come back to Him with a beautiful return. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us all the ability to help His religion in whatever capacity that we can. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He accepts from us all. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ لِسَائِلِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. If you can come up, please, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. الحمد لله على فضله وإحسانه وأشكره على توفيق امتنانه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبعد. One of the best ways that we can help as a community and as an organization and as an ummah is by supporting our Islamic centers. And why do I say that? The reason I say that is because think about the different ways that we're trying to address these issues. There's definitely a spiritual component. Alhamdulillah, masajid through qunut nazila and having salah and making dua and raising this awareness. This is a boost of all of our iman. So that's definitely the core of everything that we do. The masajid help us do that. There's an aspect of civic engagement. When politicians, they may not want to meet us as individuals, but they'll want to meet us collectively as a Muslim group and a Muslim ummah and a Muslim community. So alhamdulillah, facilitating that, the masajid help us do that as well. In terms of donations, whatever we can collect as individuals, we can exponentially collect more as a community and as an organization. Also in terms of demonstrations, organizing these, education, the masajid are the basis of all of these things. Even if you look at the history of the civil rights movement and Martin Luther King, he based it off of his church, Southern Christian Leadership Conference. So they did have a spiritual component. We as a Muslim community need to make the masajid the base of everything that we do. Why? Two main reasons. Number one, it's a reminder to all of us that we must have ikhlas. We must do things with sincerity and for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, as Muslims, we have a responsibility. And we know the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَ فَهُوَ رَدْ. That whoever does something that contradicts with the way that the Prophet ﷺ did it, that action will be rejected. To keep us religiously grounded. Yes, all of the things I mentioned, they must be in line with the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Because ultimately, as I mentioned, that our success is going to come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the only way to achieve that is to do things for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do things in accordance with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So please support your Islamic centers, Islamic organizations, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all and make us all source of goodness for ourselves, our community, and our ummah in this dunya and the akhirah. Inshallah, we'll pray qunut nazila in salah as well, and we make dua for our brothers and sisters all over the world, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, anyone going through any type of difficulty or hardship, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replace those difficulties and hardships with ease. Ameen. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجيب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقيموا الصلاة.
Hayya
La ilaha illallah istaqim wa rahimakum Allah. Make sure your lines are straight. Don't leave any gaps in between. Make sure your line is complete before starting a new line. Jazakumullahu khayran wa rahimakumullah ta'ala. Allahu akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين المظلومين في غزة اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين المظلومين في غزة
اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين المظلومين في غزة، اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم انصر إخواننا في كل مكان، اللهم انصر من نصر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم، اللهم انصر إخواننا في كل مكان، اللهم انصرهم ولا تنصر عليهم، اللهم انكر لهم ولا تمكر عليهم، اللهم ثبت أقدامهم، اللهم تقبل شهداءهم، اللهم تقبل شهداءهم، اللهم تقبل شهداءهم، اللهم حرر المسجد الأقصى، اللهم حرر المسجد الأقصى، اللهم حرر المسجد الأقصى، اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين، ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين، اللهم ألف بين قلوب المسلمين، اللهم ألف بين قلوب المسلمين، اللهم ألف بين قلوب المسلمين، يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك، يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على طاعتك، يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث، أصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين أو أقل من ذلك، اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه، اللهم اغفر المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات، ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان، ولا تجعلنا في قلوب ولا تجعل في قلوب الذين آمنوا، ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين، ونجنا برحمتك من القوم الكافرين، ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم، سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله. السلام عليكم السلام عليكم السلام عليكم.
السلام عليكم. جزاك الله خير شيخ رزوان for the beautiful reminders inshallah and may Allah reward you for that. And I just want to remind everyone that we do not have basketball this Saturday and Sunday for the youth. We do not have youth program tonight either. So inshallah, we'll resume our programs next week, inshallah. We do have Fatwa Night with Sheikh Salah Hussawi. That will be on next Friday, inshallah. That will be after Isha. We have Know Your Neighbor event that is going to be on Saturday, December 2nd, also at 1 p.m. here in the masjid. And then we have also Sheikh Mahmoud for the Qiyam on the night of Saturday, December the 2nd. So that's like Sunday morning, 45 minutes before Fajr, inshallah, here in the masjid. We have a Zoom session for the parents of special needs. That will be on Sunday, December the 3rd at 11:30. The youth game night, where they will enjoy games, competition, and prizes for 7th grade and high school, will be on Sunday the 3rd of December. For 2nd and 6th grade, 7th through 6th grade, is going to be for December 10th, Sunday, December 10th, inshallah. Registration details are included in the newsletter, so please check the newsletter for details on how to register and the details about the program itself. We have a mobile mammography that will be on Monday, December the 4th at 8:30, from 8:30 to 3 p.m. here on the ICGC campus as well. So that's going to be Monday, December the 4th from 8:30 to 3:30, inshallah. And of course, we have ongoing programs such as the Ladies' Halaqah. Every Tuesday from 12 to 2 in the Mirror Hall, room 109. We have the weekly Khatira with Imam Musa. We'll resume when he comes back, inshallah. That's on Wednesday after Isha. We also have the weekly Halaqah with Quran recitation with Sheikh Mahmoud every Saturday after Fajr. As always, Jazakumullah khair and Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have a car key. For anyone who is missing their car key, please come see us, inshallah.
So you can...